نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن الكريم والفرقان الحميد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة إن الله مع الصابرين. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: عجبا لأمر المؤمن، إن أمره كله له خير، وليس ذلك لأحد إلا للمؤمن، إن أصابته سراء شكرا فكان خيرا له، وإن أصابته ضراء صبرا فكان خيرا له. رواه مسلم. صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. ربنا يسر ولا تعسر وتمم بالخير وبك نستعين يا فتاح. ربي زدني علما. اللهم صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, we praise and we thank Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbul Izzah, Rabbul Alameen, who has created you and I, who is nurturing you and I, who is making it possible for you and I to be on the face of the earth today. We thank Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we keep on thanking Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear respected brothers and sisters, because it is only by the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we are here. It is only by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not need our actions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us for the Jannah insha'Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did so, and no one forced Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do so. No one can force or compel Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put us in Jannah. No one can compel Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put us in the fire of hell. It is solely on account of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear respected brothers and sisters, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can place us in His Jannah, and on account of His wrath, He can place us in the fire of hell. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us, and He knows our beginning to the end. Allah knows whatever we are going to do, whatever we did, and what we are going to do. We make intentions, my dear respected brothers and sisters, and in this regard, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was speaking about faith, he mentioned to us, do good actions, i'malu. He said, do actions. فَكُلٌّ مُيَسَّرٌ لِمَا خُلِقَ لَهُ. For every one of you, it has been made easy what he has been created for. Why did Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam say this? It was on account of a discussion that was taking place wherein the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created a creation for the Jannah. Do whatever they like, they will go to the Jannah, more or less. And he says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created a creation that will go to the fire of hell, and do whatever they like, they will go to the fire of hell. The Sahabas asked, O Messenger of Allah, should we not just depend upon our books and our qadr, jaffa al-qalam? The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, do not depend upon that, but do actions. Do actions, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it easy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it easy for that one who has created for the Jannah to go to Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it easy for that one who has been created for the fire of hell to go to the fire of hell. And this is why we see, my dear respected brothers and sisters, that alhamdulillah thumma alhamdulillah, we are Muslims, and we know that we have to present ourselves in the masjid for the Jum'ah Salah, especially the males. And therefore, this is why we have presented ourselves in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it easy. Now, there are many Muslims who have not presented themselves in the masjid, wherever they are. And there are males, and it is compulsory upon them to perform the Jum'ah prayer. And how does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look at that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of course, He will be angry. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned many reprimands and many warnings against those who do not perform the Jum'ah prayer. So the point is, my dear respected brothers and sisters, that we as Muslims, we have to do actions. We cannot sit back and expect that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will just take us into Jannah. And we cannot expect that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will just allow everything to fall in front of our plates. But we have to make actions for our even our sustenance. We have to make actions, my dear respected brothers and sisters. And while we traverse in this dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will cause different things to happen to us. Many a times, mashallah, we will be happy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring joyful situations. And that is good, mashallah. We as believers, we love to be happy. We, of course, we know that we have to face sadness. But if you ask any human being, would you prefer to be happy or would you prefer to be sad? Ghaliban, it is almost everyone who will say that they prefer to be happy. And mashallah, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my dear respected brothers and sisters, each and every single thing in our lives as believers, Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam taught us how to deal with it. Each and every single thing in our lives, from the moment we wake up in the morning, we open our eyes, during the day, until the night time, my dear respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us, He has taught us how to live our lives. What are the things to do? What are the things not to do? Say Bismillah before you eat. If you do not say Bismillah, what do you say in the duration? Subhanallah. Even in the night time, this religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so perfect and it is so complete. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have seen many homes being burnt up and wooden homes, concrete homes burnt up. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when you are going to sleep, out the fire. When you are going to sleep, out the fire. And he even made mention about the mouse. The mouse can just walk across, run across, and kick over that candle, kick over that lamp, and before you know it, the house is on flames. Just by one piece of garment, one cloth, one curtain, starting a fire, the entire blaze took place. Subhanallah. What is the point? The point is that even these types of details in a religion, my dear respected brothers and sisters, this is our religion of Islam. This is how a Muslim is supposed to live his life. We have to learn about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned many things to us. About living our lives day in, day out, morning, noon and night, my dear respected brothers and sisters. The actions of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have to continuously learn about them. The Sahabas, when the non-Muslims, man tashabbaha biqaumin fahuwa minhum. We as Muslims, we have to be very, very careful. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made a statement. Whosoever resembles a community, they are from amongst them. Whosoever resembles a community, they are from amongst them. And we, just to touch on it, my dear respected brothers and sisters, we have to be very careful. We know we are in the upcoming festival of Diwali. It is not a Muslim festival, but it is upon us as Muslims that we have to give the mushrikeen da'wah and we have to show an example to them as to that which is better. Some people, they are calling and they are asking the question, can we go and partake of such types of meals? What about our neighbors? We invite them for Eid and now they are inviting us for Diwali. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we can invite to Haq, but we cannot be invited to Batil. And therefore, we have to understand where we draw the line. We have to understand that what is it that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam meant when he said, man tashabbaha biqawmin fahuwa minhum. We are not supposed to be rude to the unbelievers, but everybody has their line that they have to draw. Everybody draws their line when they will go inside in their home. And Muslims draw that line. Non-Muslims also draw that line. We have many things that are similar. They eat, we also eat. We wear clothing, they also wear clothing. Mashallah, there's nothing wrong. We do things in common. But there is something called tashabbu that many a times, my dear respected brothers and sisters, that we misunderstand. And then sometimes people ask the question, you know, we as believers, we have to also be friends with the non-Muslims. And we have to look, my dear respected brothers and sisters, the point of mentioning is we don't, Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not leave it up to our own opinions. Otherwise, we will have a whole kalalu as to what should we do for Diwali, what should we do for Carnival, what should we do for Christmas, what should we do for Eid. Even on the day of Eid, we can have ikhtilaf. Why? Because we are not following what Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned to us. But the point that I am making, my dear respected brothers and sisters, the point that is being made, if we do not try to learn what Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants from us, how can we practice? How can we practice? And then we leave it up to our own intelligence and you say, you know what? There's nothing wrong with this. It seems very much humanitarian that we do like this. It seems very much with cordiality and good relations that we do like this. We should find out what we ought to do, my dear respected brothers and sisters. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like shirk. And therefore, we should not be part of anything that is associated with celebrations of with shirk. And anything that would seem to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you know what, you are angry with shirk. But we are pleased with it and we have no problem with it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. And my dear respected brothers and sisters, as we go on in our lives, There are many things that we are going to face and many things that we are going to deal with. And again, we can pick up the ahadith of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and learn about it. Many authors, mashallah, Fadail al-A'mal, Riyadh al-Salihin, are common books that people hear about. And these books, mashallah, they are sectionized so that we can pick up and we can look about the chapter of virtue of salam, the chapter of the virtue of eating and the chapter of the etiquettes of eating, the chapter of the visiting of the poor, visiting of the sick, sorry, the chapter of being amongst the poor people and loving to be amongst them. MashaAllah, the people have made it so easy that we can learn about it. Why? You and I have to know how to put Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our lives, my dear respected brothers and sisters. And it is not incumbent upon every alim that he has to only educate everyone. But, mashallah, the ulama, they are important. When you need to find out something, inshallah, find a righteous scholar and seek information from them. But talab al-ilmi faridatun ala kulli muslim. Seeking knowledge is incumbent upon every Muslim, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Everyone knows their need. Another man might not know your need. Another man might not know what you need to find out in order for you to thread upon the path of Sirat al-Mustaqim. But you may have to ask. But you have to seek. Everyone has to seek. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to see that it is everyone's own examination. What am I doing for myself? Many a times we like to point fingers. And we like to say, you know what? Such and such is coming to masjid. Such and such is doing this. Or such and such. Generally speaking, many people like to say, such and such is not doing enough. Such and such is not doing. Look at what they are doing. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we have enough of that. We have enough criticism to Islam that today many a people and many a person, they consider a Muslim as a terrorist. Many a person, this is what they are indoctrinated with, that when they look at the television, when they look at signs and they look at posters, when you see a Muslim with beard, you think he has a weapon on him. You think that it is not suitable that he be sitting on the same flight with us because he might have a bomb. He might have something that is dangerous. My dear respected brothers and sisters, when we look into the lives of the Sahabas, people did not get this impression. Yes, everything was in its proper perspective. Jihad was in its proper perspective. Dealing with people were in its proper perspective. Fighting people were in its proper perspective. But mashallah, love, kindness, affection, that was also in its proper perspective and its proper proportion. And this is why, mashallah, hundreds and hundreds of people embraced Islam. This is why hundreds and hundreds of people embraced Islam. So today, many people sit down. Oh, what are we doing? What are we doing to tell the world that Muslims are not terrorists? What are we writing about them? What about our akhlaq, my dear respected brothers and sisters? What about how we are dealing with people? We are partaking of interests. People are committing fornication, dealing with all different types of wrong outside. And no sooner do we come in a masjid, what is the alim talking about? What is the khatib talking about today? Is he going to talk about Syria? Is he going to talk about America? Is he going to talk about public relations? My dear respected brothers and sisters, mashallah, these are important topics. These are important topics. But what is more important, how the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he taught his companions, my dear respected brothers and sisters. He lived with them and he taught them about a connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He taught them about qualities like patience and perseverance. He taught them about tolerance. He taught them about treating your Muslims good. Many a times upon the topic of terrorism and blowing up people and so on, of course we have to speak about how we need to treat other people well. And of course, mashallah, as Muslims, we have to be concerned how we treat other people. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam didn't treat a Muslim to become a terrorist. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam was a Muslim. And just as how other people will fight wars, a non-Muslim will fight wars, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam also fought wars. Just as how other people will want to protect their country, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam also taught Muslims how to protect themselves. That's a fact. And that is what is going on throughout the world. But my dear respected brothers and sisters, the point is, sometimes we as Muslims, we put more emphasis to other things that we miss the objective. We miss the objective, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Why did one Sahabi, he threw away the date. He threw away the date and went out and fought in a battlefield until he again martyrdom. Was it only because he loved to kill? It was because he loved Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam first. He loved Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam first. And today when we talk about public relations, my dear respected brothers and sisters, first we as Muslims, we have to worry about our in-house problems. First we as Muslims, we have to worry about our in-house problems. Because the in-house problems is what is killing us, that we cannot win a battle, my dear respected brothers and sisters. And this is what the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam taught us. This is what the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam taught us. Why on the battlefield, when the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam was going to fight the battle of Badr, 313 against 1,000. Nabi alayhi salatu wasallam on that night, he woke up when it is mentioned the other companions were sleeping. Nabi alayhi salatu wasallam was performing salah and he was raising his hands and he was crying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was crying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For what? For you and I. For what? The Muslims who were there. For whom? The Muslims who are to come, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Oh Allah, if Islam dies, what would be with your religion? Who would know about your religion if these mujahideen die, my dear respected brothers and sisters? But they were people of akhlaq. They were people of akhlaq. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the 10 companions, Ashar al-Mubashara. Why? Why? Because of the akhlaq, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Today, we have to hold conferences about our youth. We have to hold conferences not only about our youth, about the young, the people who have gotten married yesterday. Why are they divorcing today? We have to hold divorce and marriage conferences, my dear respected brothers and sisters. We have to teach people. We have to teach the Muslims. It is incumbent upon them to learn what is it that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, what has he mentioned about these things? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, لَقَدَ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. In the lifetime of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, there's the best of examples, my dear respected brothers and sisters. And this is why we as Muslims, we have to take care of our in-house problems and our in-house issues. Many a Muslim, it is not nice to know, my dear respected brothers and sisters, how our homes are. It is not nice to know how a husband is dealing with his wife, how a wife is dealing with her husband, how the parents are dealing with their children, how the children are dealing with other children, how these Muslims are dealing with their neighbors. It is not nice, my dear respected brothers and sisters. And on account of this, the non-Muslims out there, we don't have to worry about fighting them with the sword or with the gun. We are already defeating them with our own akhlaq, with what they hear our homes, what they are hearing from our homes, what our children are telling them about Islam, what our children are telling them about their fathers, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Why? Because mothers and fathers and children are not holding on to whatever Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam has taught us. Whatever Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam has taught us. And this is so important. This is so important, my dear respected brothers and sisters, that subhanallah, even before Nobody says that we cannot deal with issues. We have to deal with issues. Whether we are ready or not, at the end of the day, issues will come. But subhanallah, how better it would be. How better it would be that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are with the patient ones. In the Holy Quran, we are commanded, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ. O those who believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He ought to be feared. If we do not learn about Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we do not learn about the qualities that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned and what he has said about halal and what he has said about haram, then how are we going to live our lives? We are going to live our lives, my dear respected brothers and sisters, in a manner that we think it is right. But a Muslim cannot live his life like that. A Muslim cannot live his life like that. A Muslim has to live his life in a manner that is pleasing to Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in order for us to do that, we have to learn about Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We cannot only learn a few things, and then the other things, my dear respected brothers and sisters, we are not practicing upon it, and we are not implementing it in our lives. And many a times, we think that we are doing so. But we have to pray to Almighty Allah. This is what the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he taught us, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Yes, we would love to be amongst the sabirun. We would love to be amongst the muhsinun. We would love to be amongst the mutasaddiqeen wal mutasaddiqat. Those who give charity. Those who give charity. Many a times Ramadan, we give a lot of charity. And that is the time when, mashallah, the heart of the believers are open. We hear that Muslim, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was most generous. Most generous, yes. But what about the rest of the year, my dear respected brothers and sisters? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam was very, very generous. And charity begins at home. Charity begins at home. Not just giving the wife and the children whatever they want. And whether they pray or they don't pray, it doesn't make a difference. No, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Charity begins at home. And wa'mur ahlaka bis salati wastabir alayha. Command your family members with salah. And you also be constant upon that. This is their problem and this is our problem. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we implement Islam partially. And what the Holy Quran teaches us is that, mashallah, we can be small in numbers. We can be small in numbers, but as long as a small group is doing what they have to do, inshallah, then we will be very, very powerful. One small masjid, one insignificant masjid in the eyes of people, in the eyes of a country, we raise our hands and make dua against the oppression and the tyranny that is taking place in the country and out of the country. Inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised we will see results. Inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised the angels will help the mujahideen in the battlefield. Inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says and promises us that we, my dear respected brothers and sisters, we will get the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our daily lives and we will know how to deal with things, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us sabr. He will give us patience, inshallah, how to deal with things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will miraculously cause our youth to be good, inshallah, when the one candle of goodness lights and then it starts to illuminate the other candles, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Until then, if we do not shape up ourselves and the Muslim Ummah does not shape up themselves, my dear respected brothers and sisters, then we will be like what Hadha Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. She asked the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Anuhlikuna wa fina salihun? Will we be destroyed, O Messenger of Allah? And there are people who are worshipping Allah. They are devout, great people who are, mashallah, they are pious. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, mashallah, there may be people who are doing good efforts. But congregational effort is what is important, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam said, there will come a time whereby, mashallah, different factions and good people might be doing what they have to do. But when evil overpowers the goodness, then of course we will see what is happening on the globe today. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me for whatever wrong I have said. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the Muslim Ummah, my dear respected brothers and sisters, and give us the tawfiq that we can implement whatever Allah and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has asked us to implement. And inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant the Muslim success wherever we are. Wa akhiru da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.